This week, our Monster Build team battles curses, spells, and the occasional zombie as they attempt to transform this rock and roll bachelor pad into a black magic manor fit for a prince of darkness. The hard rockin' homeowner has agreed to hand over his keys to our oracle of architectural audacity, Steve Watson. He's the high priest of hell raising, and he's got just 5 days to do the voodoo that Monster House do so well.
Hungry for Monster House?
Our house was great and simple, it was safe and normal, it was nice and sweet, but we all agreed we could use a change, and then something happened that was very strange. The van showed up, all our stuff went flying, in the mother's sky, until the job was done. Now it's a Monster House, it's a Monster House, it's a Monster House, and we all gone missing, it's a Monster House.
Mike Muir knows a thing or two about living on the edge. As the frontman for the legendary punk metal band Suicidal Tendencies, Mike has made a career out of testing boundaries and pushing buttons.
Puff Daddy and his friend, the Dead Fatty.
For me, my favorite number is 13. I think a lot of things that scare other people don't scare me because I realize when you look a little bit different, it usually makes sense.
But Mike's house stopped making sense a long time ago.
And my house is all spray painted, and sometimes you forget that. People will walk in, you know, the gas man or something, he does okay.
So Mike asks Steve to conjure up a design theme in keeping with his taste for the dark side.
To me, voodoo is the power to scare educated people to make them actually realize how education doesn't always mean that you're intelligent. There's a million things it can do, and that's the scary thing about it and the cool thing about it.
Mike has agreed to surrender all power over design and construction to Steve and his crew. All he'll know is what he can see from a coachman fifth wheel parked out front. But first, Steve must do his voodoo diligence. He summons his design team to help figure out how to put the devil in the details. Designer Oscar L. Buerne, decorator Jerry Schwartz, and Ellie Biana, spiritual reader at the Psychic Eye Bookstore.
Mike Muir, Suicidal Tendencies, one of the originators of hardcore punk rock. Looking at the stuff he has in his house, he's got different artifacts and voodoo masks and stuff. I'm thinking we need to take it to a different level and go with a black magic theme this week. This is just like a pre-manufactured, prefab room. It's a bunch of panels. Anything we do is gonna make this room cooler than what it is right now.
I think, you know, in this area that we're gonna walk into this room,
right,
we should have a passage, maybe.
You should have something about fire, woman. Well, everybody here is born for the woman. I really see that the devil should confront the woman as the woman probably will pray.
If she's praying to this fire, maybe she, when the door opens up, she is the door and she moves into the fire. The fire will move past her to reveal this devil.
Are you gonna put them on tracks?
Yeah, one starts to move, the other one should start to move past them.
Once this door opens, we have to continue the same feeling of
jungle kind.
Yeah,
of
like what's
real primal. Just go with the metal, you know, and make this metal jungle. And we'll also add some real live plants in it, so it's a combination of both.
How about a sacrifice table?
You can put some bones on it to make it look like people were already there, and what's the remnants of people.
What can we do to take us to the outside area?
Why don't we do like this three series of doors that open up? You know, and the first can be like this sarcophagus type front that'll open up, split, to reveal like another layer of almost like the gauziness and the wrappings of the mummy.
Right.
And that'll open up and it'll let you pass through death onto the next stage.
Hey,
you know?
Bravo, let's clap for this one.
Once we have that door, and you go through the faces.
Mm-hmm.
It's just this empty kind of Zen garden that he has going on. If we want to put some kind of barbecue for parties,
barbecue
kind of thing.
What a great place to be able to prepare all the sacrifices from the sacrifice table.
That'd be awesome.
Structure.
After you sacrifice them, you cook them.
Here's the plan. The door to the back storage room will be replaced by a Devil's Passage portal featuring three moving metal characters. Inside, they'll build a metal jungle complete with two-headed animals that turns from happy to horrible with the flip of a switch. Another portal will be built through to the backyard, featuring three motorized faces that open in sequence. The back patio will get a sacrificial dining table and a matching stone and bone cannibals barbecue.
Our shaman emerges from the spirit world. He summons forth his five monster builders.
Jeff Dunham.
Jeff Dunham, welder and metal fabricator.
Andre Basket.
Andre Basket, carpenter and construction foreman.
Rex Tedeschi,
licensed electrical contractor.
Michael Gump.
Michael Gump, toy designer and metal artist.
Miles Walters,
mechanical wizard. If they can complete the entire remodel by midnight Friday, they'll each receive tools from Akita and Aesop worth over $3,000. Mike emerges to hand over his keys and also to give Steve a warning.
I'll be keeping this for safeties. All right, and this too.
You feeling good?
I'm feeling a little nervous, though. The camera's on. You know you're nervous when you start looking like this.
The witch doctor leads his subjects inside to open his bag of black magic.
Okay, this is the first part of our build. This is the three-tiered portal going into the next room. You've got flames and fire, which is the god, and you've got the lady bowing down to the god. In this area, we're going to have our jungle. It's going to be made out of angle iron and a lot of tube steel, but we're also going to incorporate a lot of greenery ourselves and some shrubbery in here. And this is another portal into another world. This is a three-tiered panel that's going to open up to the outside. You've got your sarcophagus that opens up. Then under that is a gauze mask that opens up. And under that is the real man's face that opens up.
Now, this is the last area. Just a big barbecue roasting spit. And you got to remember to keep that 4 feet from the house, 6 feet from the wall. So as you can see, you're already in a jungle out here, so we're just basically amplifying his existing style in his house. Mike has to move back into this house, and he's got to live here. So you got to treat this place as if it's your own home. So it's got to be cool, but it's also got to be safe, and everything's got to work. And by Friday night at midnight.
Let's do it.
Monster house.
Right on.
The build kicks off by breaking a new hole through to the backyard and taking out the sliding glass door. Andre, an experienced construction foreman, tries to coordinate the demo. He starts carefully removing the door frame, one screw at a time.
That's what I call demo.
Steve shows him the monster method.
Andre's over there taking over this little damn drill and it's like, man, we gotta finish this job. That's right, Andre. Oh, you play with your drill over there.
That's it.
Watch your head there, Andre. Coming down.
The team stops to decide who's going to do what. Gump will cut out the figures for the first portal. Jeff will start creating the metal jungle. Miles will make the mechanisms for the face portal. Once they're built, Electrician Rex will wire all the motors. That leaves the barbecue for Andre.
Andre, I think, you said you had the best idea on the barbecue.
Is it because I got the best idea or for some other reason?
Come on, black barbecue.
This kind of goes together. Maybe that's just a... ironic thing, I don't know, but we'll see.
You hear me? We gotta give him something to do.
What's that, Rex?
You got this bull by your horns, by the horns, right?
We'll see.
Rex lends him a hand, but his ribbing is starting to sting.
With me not being able to take the doors apart, I guess Rex figured I was an idiot or something. I've heard my name about three times while I wasn't paying attention, while you thought I wasn't listening, while you thought I wasn't around. So we'll see how many more times we're here.
We're gonna dig a hole there, and we're gonna dig one there.
All right. I'm gonna pat him on the back. He'll feel better. Yeah. He's a happy-go-lucky guy.
Out front, Jeff meets a delivery from Industrial Metal Supply.
I'm gonna make a beautiful metal forest.
Jeff Dunham designs and builds custom metal furniture.
I'm gonna cut it up and make huge steel leaves. I'm gonna make devil people, and who knows what else. Yeah, I'll probably be back here for about 2 days, cutting and welding. Yeah, I'm gonna spearhead the artistic side of this, basically. Yeah, and then the other guys will jump in with the more mechanical side of the welding.
The lumber arrives. carpenter Andre leaves Rex to fend for himself and drafts Gump to build a wood frame for the stone table.
It's going to look like it's cement, but it's basically going to be a wood frame, wood box, and the chicken wire, and then we're going to skin on some cement. It'll look like a big cement table, but it'll be about a ton and a half lighter.
Meanwhile, Miles works out a plan for getting the motorized portals moving.
We're going to mount the sheet metal artwork onto the carriers, which will run it on the track.
Miles Walter's skills include building large-scale mechanical effects for theme parks. Gump and Andre make quick work of the frame for the sacrificial table.
We're waiting for the human bones and chicken feet and other gruesome accoutrements.
Michael Gump's claims to fame include outlandish film productions, living sculptures, and a van specially designed to freeze bugs.
Wanna make this mark again?
Today, he's going to create a black magic woman.
Try to make her sexy, like the drawing. Kind of crazy, big head, but also very sexually appealing, if you know what I mean. Nice, big, round shapes, and sort of expressionistic.
Gump brings his lady to life with a plasma cutter. Out back, Andre has reunited with Rex on the barbecue.
It's good to see that happening. I'm keeping an eye on that relationship. There's still a little friction there, I think. For a couple guys who haven't said more than two words to each other, they're making some really good headway together.
With no idle chatter to slow them down, they quickly sheet out the base.
One thing for sure, Rex, this is built very well.
Inside, Gump covers the table with chicken wire to hold a coat of concrete. By 8 p.m., the team decides to table the table and call it a night.
Tuesday.
Day two. And the builders are ready to stir up some more black magic. Miles and Jeff weld tracks for the Devil's Passage portal. Gump cuts characters out of sheet metal. And Rex and Andre are back together on the barbecue. By mid-morning, the portal track is finished. Miles and Jeff take it inside to fit it to the door frame.
It couldn't be more perfect.
But for Steve, the sacrificial table is not perfect.
It's too high to double as a dining table. And so I was just measuring it out, and it needs about 7 inches taken off the bottom.
Mainly my fault, because I didn't think about it when it was being built.
Well, good, then you can fix it. I didn't realize it was a dining room table. I thought it was for sacrificing people and collecting their blood.
Yeah, that's what it doubles as. Then the top is fine. You know, I don't want to change the top.
Andre takes the setback in stride.
Back to the room.
But Gump is a grump.
I don't really want to move backwards. I just want to keep moving forward so we can start tackling the bigger stuff. So to hear, you know, stuff that, oh yeah, we got to redo this. You know, because we didn't really like tell you what we wanted in the first place is kind of a frustration.
I don't have time to worry about that. I do have time, however, to fix the base of a table.
Suddenly, the dark forces claim another victim.
Steve sets out to make a quick fix on the table, but the table turns out to be tougher than it looks.
I'm sweating my
off. Finally, Gump gives in and lends a hand.
Sweet.
Despite these signs of progress, construction foreman Andre is getting worried.
We haven't accomplished anything, not one project. I was going to take a look around just to see where we are as a team. I'm not going to wait till Thursday to worry. I'm worried now. How much more do we have to do before we can start putting up our figures?
Hopefully about another hour welding on this. And
what is this for, the back wall?
This will be the last piece for that wall.
Good. Let me know.
How are you doing over there? You guys finishing that up?
Yeah, I'm finishing up. That's one, man. You making any progress?
Yep.
We are. You feel good about everything?
Yep.
We're going to be done by Friday?
Yep.
All right.
The response is less than overwhelming.
I think it motivated everybody. It reminded them that what we're doing, instead of just getting lost in your project and kind of moseying along, I think it picked up the morale and picked up the momentum.
Out back, Gump is dancing with the devil.
I call him Mr. Madness. He's gonna actually need another leg that comes out here, another arm that comes up behind this headpiece.
Just because I'm goofy or scary looking or whatever, people assume a lot of things about me. Kids are scared of me at the grocery store.
He is a little out there. He's a lot out there.
In these dreadlocks, I've cleverly put these snaps so you can see. Snap, and we can take a snap and snap it so that my hair is interchangeable with other snaps.
Even I have my reservations about myself.
Jeff is hacking away at his metal jungle.
Very large blades of grass.
Miles gets started on a track for the second portal.
We're gonna have three different sets of tracks in there, opening three different doors.
But despite all these noses to the grindstone, the immensity of the work left to do is beginning to hit home.
The welding and all the metal cutting and all this is just a massive job. You know, it's like all day, every day.
There's an hour's worth right there, you know.
We've only begun to skim the surface in the amount of work that we're gonna have to do. I've just been sketching stuff out and cutting it all day.
So there's probably more than a ton of metal here. And I don't know if we're gonna be able to get the deadline.
As the day winds down, the team starts playing with fire.
I gotta tell you, it's pretty cool.
Okay. Come on,
Gump. Daddy Gump gives his little girl away.
Dude, I like that.
With the devil's portal in place, the builders decide to call it a night.
You guys get some rest tonight. It's only day two. We got three more of these to go.
Får du också munsår när du som minst behöver det? För att bli av med herpesmunsår snabbt, använd Vectavir, Sveriges populäraste receptfria kräm mot munsår. Vectavir lindrar smärtan och påskyndar läkningen. Och det verkar snabbt från de första symptomen till blåsorna. Vectavir, bara 4 dagars behandlingstid.
Vi på 3 tycker att du ska kunna se den du pratar med. Därför får du den senaste 3G-mobilen utan extra kostnad. 300 minuter att ringa för dygnet runt till alla nät. 0 kronor till alla inom 3. Allt för 199 kronor i månaden. Köp på 3.se 020 33 33 33 eller i närmaste butik. Vi ses. 3. Between friends.
The ringleader.
What are we stealing?
The talent.
Huh.
The wannabe. And that's not all.
I'm arresting you.
Ocean's 12. Buy it on DVD.
Köp Ocean's 12 hos discshop.se.
På trygghansa.se har vi samlat råd och tips på hur du kan skydda ditt hem mot inbrott.
Man kan inte festa varje kväll!
Där kan du givetvis även teckna försäkringar.
Nu kommer jag in!
Somewhere beyond the sea. Somewhere waiting for me. My lover stands on golden sand.
Del Mar, the new fragrance from Baldessarini, separates the men from the boys.
250 matcher från Allsvenskan och Elitserien. Bara för dig som har Kanal Plus. Säsongskortet med 250 matcher från Allsvenskan och Elitserien för 99 kronor i månaden. Ring Kanal Digital på 020 27 00 27.
Mina vänner, i tusental år!
Just nu är drömvinsten uppe i 87 miljoner. Spela lotto med Joker.
Nu blir Halebop kontantkort ännu billigare. Ring för 0 kronor per minut till alla andra med Halebop. Och för 99 euro per minut till resten, dygnet runt. Skaffa Halebop idag och ta med ditt gamla nummer. Plocka fram din mobil och smsa byt och ditt personnummer till 72333 så skickar vi ett kontantkort hem till dig gratis. Och du, tipsa alla du känner så blir det ännu billigare.
Okej, en Whopper. Extra spicy dressing, extra pepperoni, extra ost.
Cool.
En dubbel Whopper. Yoghurt dressing, extra bacon, extra ost.
Cool.
En Whopper. Inget extra?
Också coolt.
の時間だ。今日のちゃんこは
ビタリネや見たことないな。
うん、すごいクリーミー。
本当にクリーミーだ。
ちょっと待ってよ、脂肪分がないよこれ。糖分入ってないよ。
Vitalinea är härligt krämig och smakar fantastiskt, men innehåller trots det bara 0,1% fett och inget vanligt socker.
Mm.
Torr hud. Glöm det. Med den bästa Nivea bodymilk någonsin kan du fira att du för alltid kan ta farväl av torr hud. Den nya förbättrade formulan är berikad med naturliga mineraler. Nya Nivea bodymilk. Farväl till torr hud.
Hej! Vill du få information om polisens fartkontroller? Smsa koden RADAR till nummer 72333 så får du ett meddelande när området är övervakat.
Ahlgrens bilar, Sveriges mest köpta bil.
Det tog massor av timmar att spola bort.
Jag kan lära dig rätt.
Innan hade vi ingen så alla barn blev jätteglada.
Själv Göran är jättesnäll.
Han kom dit varje kväll att spola banan hela vintern.
Har du en isbana?
Tack för att jag har det, så det är så.
Jaha, vet du vad? Den har Göran gjort helt själv.
Träffa en snubbe som vill att jag skulle haka upp till hans rum. Jag var inte sugen och knäppte till, för jag ville kolla in hans nya puffrö. Stack till operan och träffa en cellobrut som försökte skjuta mig, men det hade hon inget för. Så vi drog till Wien istället och åkte till berg- och dalbanan. Mellanlanda på kontoret för att spana in Qs nya manicker och Moneypennys nya brillor innan vi drog till Marocko. Efter det är allt suddigt.
Must have scared the living daylights out of me.
James Bond är tillbaka i iskallt uppdrag fredag klockan 9 här i Kanal 5.
Wednesday!
Hump day.
It is hump day.
Wednesday morning, and the boys carpool to work, Gump style.
All right, it is Wednesday, our third day of the build, and we're just getting started this morning. Rex is finally getting on some of this rough electric to make all of our things work. Then he's going to hopefully start working on some of the machines and get power to all the different areas that we need to get power to. I feel confident he's going to knock that out for us today.
Right on, Steve.
This is one of the major builds in this project. We've got our lady up here. We got our flames. The devil's back there ready to be mounted. The biggest problem of this and my biggest concern is making it move. My biggest concern about this entire build has been this three-panel face, our sarcophagus. This is a good two-week project, and it hasn't been addressed yet. So hopefully they have some sort of a plan, and they can communicate that to me later on.
But communication isn't this team's strong suit. Steve is beginning to have a sense of deja voodoo.
There's a lot of work getting done, but this is my 13th time doing this. 11 out of 12 times, I've had guys who got it done on time, but those guys had an energy that we just don't have right now. And they had a communication among all five of them that we don't have right now. And the one time that we didn't have communication, where it was five guys who individually do really good work, that team didn't make it. And I don't want this 13th house to be one that doesn't make it. I'm gonna drive you crazy with reminding you what time it is, how much time is left.
I'm ready to kick it up. I mean, right. The first couple days, good. We had a good flow. We got the base of everything kind of going, but now it's time to slam it together.
But let's pick it up now.
Miles is done with the track for the face portal, and Andre helps him mount it to the concrete floor. Jeff gets back to his rumble in the jungle.
Okay, these are just randomly bent wire that we're gonna use as stems to weld our tiny leaves to that we were bending outside. We're just kinda gonna freestyle it and make our forest.
Rex wires a motor for the Devil's Passage.
How long until we can get this stuff moving? What do you think?
Well, this motor will be ready to turn in about 15 minutes.
While Rex runs wire, Miles creates a pulley system from a good old-fashioned bicycle chain.
We're ready to test this motor out and do some final adjustments and put in the limit switches so we can stop them when we want to stop them. Okay. If it doesn't work, it's Mr. Miles' pulley system screwed up. If it does work, my motor is working perfect. Ready, gentlemen? A drum roll.
It works on the first try, and the lady and the fire are on the move. Out front, a gruesome delivery arrives.
A human bone.
They're plastic human bones.
And Mike gets himself a roommate.
I'm Wendell, Mike's girlfriend. Just here for the show, representing Australia, of course. Not surprised that he's doing this, especially the Black Magic one. It's pretty much Mike all around, so.
Late afternoon, and the team has been working in near silence all day. With progress slow and the deadline looming, Steve is getting worried.
This team works, and they do good work, and they get a lot done, but these guys don't say a single word to each other. And it's confusing the hell out of me. This guy hasn't said a word in half an hour. Somebody say something now! Well, there went that shot.
Andre takes another stab at corralling these wordless workers.
Andre's calling a quick meeting. Hey, Gump!
I think we forgot what we're here for. We're here to complete something with a deadline. And we forgot that completely. We're not done with anything. We do something, a portion of it, and we just think it's time to have a parade, it's time to party. It's not. We're so engaged in our craftsmanship, we're so in love with what we're doing, and we're forgetting about the deadline.
I don't really agree with you. I think everybody's doing a great job. You know?
Everybody's doing a fantastic job.
I haven't seen anybody have parading around admiring what they're doing too much. I think everybody's just trying to get what they're doing.
And I don't think anybody's really slacking or anything like that.
No one's slacking.
Once again, Andre's rallying cry falls on deaf ears.
Andre has kind of stepped up in his own mind as the leader of the team, but I got to tell you, 4 out of 5 builders don't feel the same way.
They were not going to jump on board with the guy. They weren't seeing what he was seeing, which I think is a shame.
I feel like he was kind of pointing the finger at me. Because things are being too slow or trying to be too creative or something.
I think Andre is just wasting our time by calling meetings, telling us about his problems.
And frankly, I think they're mad at me, which is fine. I don't care if they hate me at this thing.
I'm gonna push the button some more, and in fact, I'm gonna try to make them hate me. Just as long as we win.
Thursday!
Day four, and the team arrives ready to have at it. But this morning, they're one man down.
One, two, three, four.
There's only four.
What happens if Andre bailed? Where is he?
You're bad.
The boys can't help but wonder if Andre has thrown in the towel.
I don't know. I kind of think maybe he bailed. Maybe it's for the best.
I'm really hoping it's not, you know, something, you know, that he didn't freak out or something. He's kind of been on a rock.
I think some of the guys think that he probably just got in the car and split and went back home with his tail between his legs, but I don't think that's Andre.
The team shrugs off the distraction and leaps headlong into the face portal project. Gump turns a pile of pencil rod into frames for the faces. Miles works on another pulley system. And Rex wrestles with a tangle of wires and switches.
You can see, this is our three-door system. This is our one slide system before. That was the drawing to make that one work. Now we got that one right there. So it's just a matter of getting all that into this box here.
Jeff disappears into his jungle.
Working on this force is going to take up my full day.
Finally, Andre arrives.
Hey, Jeff.
Hey, dude.
Good morning, man.
Good morning.
Gump, Miles, I'm here.
All right.
Good morning, good morning.
You scared us.
Nice to see you.
Too many times on the snooze?
A couple.
I overslept, which isn't good. Kind of lose some respect and some power if you do have power. I'll do everything I can to get back on the right page.
But Steve is still worried that these five busy builders aren't adding up to a team.
It's mid-morning on Thursday. There's still a lot of work to get done. I think for some reason, they're all doing individual things, not communicating again. Jeff, still working on the forest. Gump is over there working on the face, got the frames built for the face. Andre, still working on the grill. Still, for the fourth day in a row. Rex is doing all the electricals. He's by himself. And Miles is working on the frame. There's no communication whatsoever. And in my experience, that's not how you pull this challenge off. I have no idea if these guys are gonna pull this off or not.
Yeah, hey, little concerned what's going on here. You got these people. I'm trying to pull it together, but you know, it's just...
There's nothing you could have done to make that suck anymore.
But things don't suck back in the metal shop.
This is exactly what I was wanting to see. This is the frame, and I got it. This looks great.
Jeff gives Gump's lady a full body makeover.
Supposed to apply it to a funky color. It's like a metal stain.
And Gump gets a little jealous.
I was a little bit concerned the way he's touching my lady, but it's unbecoming of gentlemen to get into fisticuffs over a female.
Hey, you brought this lady to this party.
That's right. That's right.
Late morning, and time for a visit from monster decorator Jerry Schwartz.
Don't hurt yourself, boy. It's awesome. It's amazing in here. It's gonna kick butt. It's the Black Magic House, and I've got some amazing accessories and touches for this house that's gonna make it creepy. Altars, red, drippy blood candles, a little bit of everything. It's gonna be awesome. And I have some other secret things in my car that I'm not going to show you guys yet, because you'll have to see for the reveal.
Out back, Andre's methodical pace is chewing up time this team doesn't have.
It is taking longer than expected, but it will be done today.
Andre isn't the only team member who's bogged down. Miles is struggling to make the many welds needed for the face portal.
Probably done maybe 50% of the welding that I need to do. And that's probably giving me a high number. It's probably a little more like 35%. By the time I finish this job, I'll probably have done somewhere in the neighborhood of 1,000 welds.
Rex is wrestling with another challenge, getting the face portal to open in three separate stages.
Rex wired it up so that our first motor starts opening the door, gives it a bit of time, then our second motor kicks in and that starts opening, and then our third motor will kick in and then it'll open.
Out in the summer sun, Gump is melting like a box of chocolates.
It's hotter than hell out here!
I think Gump could probably use a nap.
He finishes the face frames and heads into the jungle.
This is gonna, you know, have to happen. Here's the animal. It's this plate, and then here's his head.
They also need to figure out a way to make the jungle animals switch from happy to horrible.
Two guys, sprocket, one motor over here. Two guys over there, one motor.
And we've got Gump. He's been great on cutting all of our shapes and coming up with pretty wild creations. Normal cat, angry cat.
Jeff adds a rusting agent to the leaves and trees. Miles and Rex start mounting Gump's face frames to a guide track. Outside, Andre is still struggling to catch up. He turns to a teammate for help.
Say, Jeff.
Yeah.
Is there any way that you and I can go out here and finish this? This is going kind of slow. Let's go out here and give me a hand with this, and then we'll both do this together. Okay, what you gonna do is whatever I ask you to do. And use some,
hey, Miles.
Some common sense as far as what I'm doing next. So what we're doing?
I don't have any of that. This is just normally what I do. I'd rather finish what I normally do. You know, because I have plenty to do, as well as he has plenty to do.
Jeff walks away.
Now he wants to pull me away from what I'm doing at the last minute when I'm trying to wrap up my thing to mix concrete. I think it's ridiculous. I think we should continue doing exactly what we've done.
As the day slips away, Miles and Rex bear down on the face frames. Gump cuts more creatures. And Andre finally puts the barbecue to bed. 28 hours to go, and the jungle is taking shape.
The jungle's basically done except for a little bit of touch-up, which we can do tomorrow in, you know, 20 minutes.
Meanwhile, Miles and Rex are ready to take the first face for a ride.
Check this out. Yeah.
That's our first door action there.
With momentum on their side, Rex pushes for a late-night rally.
Well, we're gonna get the rest of these doors in and working tonight.
It'd be really nice. I mean, I would probably sleep better if we know that those three are working, and then it's a
matter of making them look good.
So, yeah.
I thought I was gonna die a while ago, but now I feel great.
Feel better. All right.
I'm so cool, bud.
But dark forces are pulling at Jeff's team spirit.
We're sure to stay here all night and not be able to do anything tomorrow.
I mean, everybody. Yeah, if you're really tired, that's no problem. I mean, Get some rest.
Jeff decides to stay. But the dark spirits have not gone away. Andre moves inside to give the sacrificial table a coat of concrete. And this time, Jeff lends a hand. At just before midnight, the second portal is in place.
We're into day five.
With exhaustion setting in, Rex's late-night gamble promises to either push the team over the top or over the edge. Friday morning, and the guys shuffle in like the walking dead. But the decision to work late last night is looking like a saving grace. The table, barbecue, and jungle are all finished.
Rex, say what you will about this guy. If it wasn't for the fact that he talked all these guys into working until 1 and 2 o'clock last night, I'd be sitting on the beach right now because I would know for a fact there's no chance in hell these guys would get this thing done.
But they still need to get the animal head spinning and cover the three faces with sheet metal.
You told me.
Gump has come up with the bright idea of mounting the two-headed animals to a windshield wiper motor.
It's close. Oh, there we go.
Lyckad festival, eller hur?
Mm-hmm.
Men det blev visst rätt sent.
Nya Nivea For Men Energy Cream Q10 återfuktar huden och ger ditt ansikte ny energi.
Jag förstår inte varför vi krånglar till det sådär.
Prova nya Energy Cream Q10, ansiktsvård från Nivea For Men.
Mm-hmm.
Och nu till vädret. Ett kraftigt nederbördsområde.
Nu finns Friggs multivitaminmineral för alla i familjen i din vanliga mataffär.
Jag tycker att du ska kunna se den du pratar med. Därför får du den senaste 3G-mobilen utan extra kostnad. 300 minuter att ringa för dygnet runt till alla nät. 0 kronor till alla inom 3. Allt för 199 kronor i månaden. Köp på 3.se 020 33 33 33 eller i närmaste butik. Vi ses. 3. Between friends.
Mina vänner! Tusental år!
Just nu är drömvinsten uppe i 87 miljoner. Spela lotto med Joker.
Massera huden när du duschar. Nya Nivea Firming Shower har ett justerbart massagehuvud för märkbart fastare hud. Det finns ingen anledning att dölja så fast hud. Nya Firming Shower från Nivea.
HP Blade System. Servrar med kraftfulla Intel Xeon-processorer. Konsolidering på ett enkelt sätt.
Där kärleken är det dödligaste vapnet. En ny succéfilm av regissören och producenterna till Hero och Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon. Flying Daggers. Nu på video. Köp filmen på cdhom.com.
Roja directa. El árbitro mantiene la decisión. Hay tiro libre.
La pelota hizo una comba impresionante.
Uno, dos. Derechazo. Gol!
Exceptionellt bra bild i världens tunnaste DLP flat screen. En innovation från Thomson Senior.
Jag satte den. Såg du?
Kul, vad bra. Du är jätteduktig.
Kanske har du råd med mer än du tror. Prata med oss om bolån i Nordea. Ring 020 51 10 00. Gör det möjligt.
Känner du till hemligheten bakom min höga ålder? Svara och vinn bildäck!
Vill du köra en ny Opel under en hel månad? Med chans att vinna bilen för alltid? Ansök till Opel Selected Driver hos din Opelhandlare senast den 17 april.
Redan nu har du chansen att rösta fram din favorit Big Brother-deltagare. Vem är roligast, tråkigast, sämst och bäst?
Lite mer hinner tillbaka.
Du bestämmer. De två som får minst röster åker ut. Och vilka det blir ser du på söndag i Big Brother Live. Söndag klockan 9 här i kanal 5.
Another shipment of steel arrives, and Andre tries his hand at plasma cutting.
Finally, we have our first piece of sheet metal coming up to test it out. This is what I'm talking about. This needs to happen with quickness for this to be a successful build.
Honestly, I would have liked to started this earlier. It's going to take something really special for us to get through this.
Steve is beginning to think that the late night drove the demons away.
For the first time all week, we have all five builders in the same space working together trying to get this thing done. Andre's gotten in some of the metalwork. He brought the sawhorses in so that he and Jeff could just cut the sheet metal and toss it over. So it's almost like we have a little assembly line going on right here.
Steve brings in a little extra motivation.
All right, guys, just to keep you going, I'll bring your friend inside for you.
Thanks, Steve.
13 hours.
Exactly.
Okay, hold it. That's perfect. I got three more of these switches to go, and the door will be fully operational.
Now see, this is what I like about Friday. Thank God it's Friday.
I really like what's going on with the team right now. It seems like everyone's kind of really pulled together. Everyone's kind of like paired up. It's looking good.
By 2 p.m., the first face is showing signs of life.
Right now we've got one half of our sarcophagus part of the face sheeted out, and then you have to go to the other half. Andre's finally getting the animals up, and the guys are filling the trunk.
Somebody pass me that damn Stanley hammer, please.
But despite all this progress, the dark reality of midnight is only getting nearer.
I think we did this first half mask in about 4 hours, which is kind of scary, because if it takes that long to do the second one, that's 8 hours. We have 9 hours, and we still have two other ones to do.
Steve turns the heat up a notch.
All right, guys, 2 seconds. 2 seconds, please. 2 seconds. All right. Do I have everybody here? Can I get everybody's attention, please? Is that impossible? Guys, listen to me.
What's up?
Miles, this is what you're playing for right now, okay? This is how much time you have. Now, this thing can be done. I'm letting you know. I've been here. This can be pulled off. But you got to keep it to the grindstone and keep it going. There's no time to second guess yourself. There's no time to overthink processes or anything. We got to just keep going forward, go with your first instinct on things, and just make it happen. All right, you guys can pull this thing off. The way that just went, and the way the people, these guys just didn't seem to care. At this point, my hand.
I'm whatever you're saying, this is like just pedal to the metal. That's what we're trying to do. We don't have a lot of things to talk about.
Like we're just like say like, okay, it's a good idea. Yeah, let's do it. Let's work it.
It's not okay to ignore somebody when they're trying to motivate you. That's what's not okay.
Okay, you want to finish your motivation?
Doesn't matter now. I'll see you guys at midnight.
Hey, real quick, go.
Can you hold it?
What's that?
How can we make good on what just happened?
Dig deep inside you and
finish. We have to finish, not talk about nothing. We already know what we got to do.
I'll think about it. I didn't really mean like to suggest that I wasn't listening to his speech. I thought like
the speech was interesting. I thought it was kind of over, and I just wanted to get back to work.
Well, let's make good on it.
Okay.
Get it done, like done.
Well, let me know if you have any suggestions.
Okay,
about
just
that.
let's get going. Okay. Brex, you walked away while he was talking.
I know. I gotta work.
Okay, can we help us?
Typical.
Sorry. I'm gonna hold it. I don't ever plan on stopping for dinner.
Okay.
So it's not a matter of not stopping for him. It's a matter of not stopping for dinner, not stopping to the bathroom, not stopping for anything.
Got it. That's it.
Andre realizes that Steve's two hands could make or break this build team.
Steve is our teammate. You want to get him back in the game?
This time, he's not going to let the team's indifference stop him.
Just go say, Steve, can you give us your input on anything? Just go tell him you're sorry. Anything.
I'll go ahead and tell him that I think it's kind of a misunderstanding.
Go tell him that. Go tell him that it's a misunderstanding.
You think it's worth our time?
I think it's worth our time.
Okay, Andre.
I'll give you a hand.
Anything on this, for you.
Jeff. Thanks. Come on, Jeff. I'll give you a hand.
I just wanted to apologize for being kind of a hothead. You know, Andre's asked me to be, cooler with you. And
I'm just trying to give you guys a little motivation. Nobody wants to hear it. It's like, whatever.
Okay. I just thought that you'd said what you wanted to say, and I apologize. Whatever.
Nothing to apologize for. It's just another Friday.
We're both a little hot-headed.
Yeah.
We can both admit that. We're both man enough to say, we both have hot heads.
It has been well documented that I'm hot-headed.
Andre wanted me to come apologize. Whatever.
Only for Andre. Only for Andre.
Come on.
Let's go.
Now it's Rex's turn to mend fences.
Hey, I hope you didn't think I was rude earlier.
Oh, no, I thought you were an ass. I won't lie to you.
Well, I was thinking about wiring diagrams in my head because I didn't have time to put it on paper. That's all I was thinking about.
Idiot.
If I lost train of thought, I wouldn't have my phone.
Yeah, not hurt my feelings.
Having done what he can to patch up this tattered team, Andre goes back to work.
The reason I'm so emotional about this project is because you only get to do it once. I can't even prepare myself to lose. I can't do it. My mind just won't go. I can't fix my mind to think of me driving away and saying, that's the end of it.
But his persistence pays off. Steve jumps back into the fray and tackles what's left of the Devil's Portal. By 7:30, another project is off the list.
Oh, I'm threatening. Rex, go work on something else, brother. This thing is finished. Look at that. If the ship goes down, damn it, I'm going down with it.
4 hours to go, and the noose is getting tighter. Rex and Andre work feverishly on the animal heads. While the face portal swallows Jeff, Miles, and Gump.
We're this close, but we have this much time.
Hey, come out.
As the pressure mounts, even Gump cuts the clowning.
Dad!
Hey, come on, let's stop joking around. Let's just get through this, huh?
And the guys disappear into a shower of sparks.
All right, guys. 2 hours. 2 hours.
2 hours.
Here we go, fellas. 2 hours. This is what Monster House is about right here.
Yeah! Yeah!
Rex turns on the animals.
Cody's nice.
Got the wild head.
Done. The forest is done. Guys, 1 hour, 18 minutes left. The only thing left is that. Everything else is a completion. That's it. Just wanted you guys to know.
Just roll.
Everything's a funnel right there. Go for it.
Come on.
Thank you.
rounds, 1 hour. 60 minutes, 1 hour.
With just 30 minutes left, Miles puts the final weld on the faces. But now the hex is on Rex.
Right now, this second door is bound on something. We can't find what it is. We can't figure it out. If this door doesn't move, this is not a successful part of the build. This is the main thing. It has to move.
The third and final portal refuses to open. Rex finds a problem with one of the limit switches.
I think I'll be able to. There we go. There's a switch that it hits that goes up and it makes it stop. That got caught in the foot in the wheel and got bent under. So we got to straighten it out, and it's stuck in that in the track.
Up in the middle. Up in the middle.
All right, that's a good sign.
That's a good sign. Rex. Love you, Rex.
Now let's...
Down.
Down.
All right, good work.
I'll put it on the side.
10 minutes to go, and the final portal still won't open.
Just me. That's okay. We could adjust that one.
Okay, number three.
No, number one.
Okay, up.
Good.
Down, down.
Now you see more of that back face.
Yeah. All right, watch it.
Up. Up.
You gotta be right.
You got 2 minutes.
Really pulling on one side.
Okay, down, down. All the way down.
What up. Happened?
Less than a minute, come on now.
Go down.
Yeah. Got it.
Hurry.
That's time. It's midnight.
Well, that's it, Lip Rex.
I can't even prepare myself. I can't do it.
Huh?
He's driving away.
Make it run for me one more time.
Evil spirits, be gone!
You guys are Monster House Rex.
Woo!
Jump. Thank you.
Thank you. The cheerleader.
The crew. Guys, listen, hold up.
All three of you guys.
You guys get prizes. You get an 18-volt cordless combo kit by Makita, a Makita 10-inch dual-slide compound miter saw, and a Precision Master outfit from Prestolite. Again, thank you very much. I told you, pulling it off.
Saturday, and Jerry has just 12 hours to turn this construction site into a room with a voodoo.
We've got leafage. I went everywhere, from Venice Beach to South Central to all over the place. I got these amazing bones at Necromance. Fix his hair. And I found tarantulas. I thought they were sacrificial, spooky, because I wouldn't want them crawling on me. The metal jungle is all lit up by IKEA spots.
The place looks great. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Steve. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
They just told us about 45 minutes to go before we check it out. So how you feeling?
Pretty nervous, but it's not my house. I think you should be feeling pretty nervous.
How, check the hand test?
Yeah.
I would hate to like get in there and actually like just go, oh my gosh, this is just like, I don't know what it is. I don't know what it's supposed to be.
After a spooky week in the RV, it's time for Mike and Lindell to find out if this voodoo house will be a blessing or a curse.
Come on in. Are you guys ready? Oh no!
What?
See, the flame's gonna open up. to expose the devil.
Oh my God.
What is it?
We go in?
I think you gotta go in.
Oh my God. It doesn't look like you have.
Oh damn. Oops,
man. But I always, when people come to my house, they always do that look around, and that's what I'm doing.
Well, they're gonna look around at this one. You have this big metal forest over here that actually changes.
Oh, no.
No! Oh,
no.
See?
And then it's, monkey turns into devil.
And then it's happy. Depending on what kind of mood you're in.
Oh, yeah. I like it. I like it. I think I'm about to get a little shaky in a second.
You see this big industrial metal sarcophagus there?
Oh, my God. That's cool.
Oh, wait.
Something in the backyard there.
We know you like to barbecue. You like to entertain. Well, let's go on outside and check out your new barbecue area. Look at this big bitch badass barbecue right there. You got your prep table over here that's also made out of concrete. This is actually a sacrificial table. You know, you're up here, you're preparing your meat or whatever it is you're gonna sacrifice. Throw it right over here on your barbecue. You got the rotisserie. This thing was handmade by Andre and Rex. They put this thing together.
That is bad.
Concrete. This thing will be here forever. This is not going anywhere.
I ain't going nowhere either.
You're also wired up with a 5.1 surround sound system inside.
Is he a just-in-time?
Yes, and, and you've also got big rock speakers here and back by the pool, so you're wired up everywhere for sound. You seem like you're a little bit in shock right now.
I'm a little in shock.
Okay, is there anything?
It's a lot more actually than I thought.
What is there anything you don't like? Anything that's kind of crazy?
No, there's nothing I don't like.
Really?
Yeah.
Good.
Nothing I don't like.
Okay, and there's some guys in there I think that want to say hello to you. Let's go say hello to these builders.
Let's do it.
Guys.
Great job.
Thanks.
You like it?
Good.
Thanks. Thanks, man.
I know you guys worked hard, man.
Thank you so much.
I ate the whole cow myself.
I'm not worthy.
I'm sure our baby will look prettier than that, but.
Until next time, when who knows, the monster may be coming to your house.
Ja, det här skrämmande huset var säsongens sista ombyggnation och vi hoppas få se mer av Monster House till hösten. Så nästa fredag klockan 7 är det kändissyskon som tar över och delar med sig av skandaler och goda minnen i All Access. Och redan nu är det All Access som har koll på vem som hånglat med vem.
Nu är det äntligen dags.
Ser.
Från Manhattan till Hollywood. Här kommer en hälsning från Joey.
Hey, I'm here in California, my new home, at one of LA's famous nude beaches. Huh? Hey, can I help you make a sandcastle?
Ny serie, nya vänner, samma Joey. Premiär tisdag den 26 april här i Kanal 5.
I Casino Las Vegas imorgon. Vinstpotten växer och deltagarna mutar sig kvar i tävlingen.
38 000. Och det är cash.
Men även girigheten har sitt pris.
Du loser i mina ögon och kommer alltid vara.
Some people have it coming.
Jag vill inte att hon stannar kvar.
They don't need any pushing.
Skulle jag vinna så kan stilen bli nu.
Shit också!
Så kommer de att gråta varje gång de åker hem.
Casino Las Vegas imorgon klockan 8 här i Kanal 5.
How you like that?
For 7.5 years I've worked alongside him, and I'm proud to have been his partner, and we've had triumphs, we've made some mistakes, we've had some sex, we've had some sex, we've had some sex setbacks. Sometimes I feel like the,
Världens roligaste ögonblick.
Tycker Filip och Fredrik.
På måndag klockan 10 här i Kanal 5.
Ja.
Sylvester Stallone är tillbaka i ringen i Rocky 5 kvart i 12. Och klockan 9 är James Bond agenten på iskallt uppdrag. Sexiga Timothy Dalton är agent 007. Nu hångel på alla plan, mer eller mindre chockerande.